From the signing table. So, I guess we'll just like do questions and answers, and you can tell me stories, I'll tell you stories. We can do whatever we want to do. I see a hand.
How does it feel to be so good looking?
It seems just fine. Now I'm going to be red the whole time I walk in. Yes.
Where'd you get your shoes?
These shoes actually are a very befitting story because in the first season, they asked if I had any input on what I wanted the character to look like, and I didn't have any idea. But, you know, that's the wardrobe people's, that's what they do, you know, that's what they're good at. But I do like boots, and so I found these boots in a store and I told them about it. So they tried to order them, but they had the hardest time getting them to the set. So it wasn't until the end of the season when we were doing our photo shoot, which is actually one of those pictures over there. And the shoes finally came in, and they just gave them to me as a gift, so I got to keep them. Which they would actually suck if it was actually my real shoe on the show, because they'd leak water on the side, and we're always shooting in the rain and the snow. So you want a functional boot on this show. Any other questions? Yes.
Which character did you prefer to play? The evil, or...?
Ooh, you know...
What was the question?
The question was, what character did I prefer playing? It's because it's always Hal, but last season, in the third season, I got to do the evil Hal because he was infected with the eye bug. And that's the most fun I've ever had working as an actor on anything. Would I want to do that all the time? Probably. But I do like the good side of Hal as well. It was great to be able to have the both sides, do a little this, do a little that. And anytime I get to work with Noah, it's always fun because I mean, he's a really great actor. It makes you show up and be as good as you can be.
Right.
And then when you get to beat him up and kick him around, that's kind of fun too. Yes?
How's the Pee-wee Baby collection going along?
The Pee-wee Baby collection. All right, so she's referring back to the iCarly days. You know? I actually had some Beanie Babies like a long time ago because I have a sister and so she collected them. And just as any siblings, there's a little bit of a rivalry. So I was like, oh, if she's going to have some, I need a couple. So I did own a few, but I don't have any anymore. I love that character though. When I actually got it, I was telling, I think you guys, that when I first booked it, I was supposed to be Miranda Cosgrove's boyfriend for a while to come, but then I booked another movie. And I couldn't do it. I couldn't continue the obligation to iCarly. So they had to figure out some way to write me out. And it was the Beanie Baby idea, or the Pee-wee Baby. So we literally had shot the first half where I'm this smooth, cool, bad boy who steals motorcycles. And then the new draft came out. I think the draft came out around midnight, because I remember reading it at night. And I'm reading through it and I'm all excited. It's the first show I've ever guest starred on. So I'm nervous, I'm excited. I get to the part where she comes into my bedroom and I punched a hole in the wall and that's manly. There was something else and it was manly, and then we go in for the kiss and she sees all of them on the wall. And I didn't know what to think. I was like, oh, my buddy's back home, we're gonna laugh. And they did. But I actually ended up loving doing it. It was as silly as could be, but I loved it. Yes.
Was she a good kisser?
Was she a good kisser? That was the most awkward kiss I've ever had. Not anything to do with her, but I was 23 at the time and she was 15.
Oh,
so
yeah.
That's why it was awkward. Her mom was right there, I'm right here. I think in the episode I kissed her 5 times. That means when we're shooting it, I might have kissed her more than any other girl in my whole life. It was ridiculous. But she was super cool, really nice, fun to hang out with. And I was the first guest star I ever did, so I was nervous. Yes, you again.
Who's a better kisser, Miley Cyrus or
Well, in actuality, we never see a kiss on Hannah Montana because it was always obstructed, wasn't it?
But you know.
I don't know. Do I know? Do I not know? Who knows? Because that was Disney's thing, was to always obstruct the kiss. We'd go in and somebody would break it up.
It's too influential.
Yeah. Yeah, I can't be corrupting you little children. Yes.
What do you think of Miley Cyrus now?
You know, I think she's the same girl that she was back when I worked with her. I don't think she's changed at all. I don't think that what she's doing is wild and crazy. She's just always, I mean, her personality is just, she's fun. She just does whatever she wants to do. And I see the shocking side of things and the tabloids and publicity have definitely like blown it up, but I don't hate her for it at all. She was so under a magnifying glass being on the Disney Channel and being her character that as soon as she was out of that, I think she just wanted to just be herself. So she did a little twerking, you know. But she's really nice. I mean, we'd go out to lunch and stuff while we were working. I really enjoyed working with her. Yes.
Can you twerk?
Can I twerk?
Can you give an example?
I've actually never even seen the video, so I'm not even sure what twerking is.
Oh my. It's just you move your butt around.
I'm sure I can move my butt around.
Can you show me?
No, no example. Here it is, right there. There's my butt moving around. Gotta watch the video. I've never seen it. Or should I watch it? Should I or should I not?
If you wanted to remember her as a friend.
Oh, I'm sure you've seen all your friends do worse. Right? Like when you're just partying or having a good time, goofing around. This is a good time. Yes.
What character on Bugs Guys do you think has gone through the most development throughout the season?
Let's see. So the question was, what character on Falling Skies has gone through the most development? Probably Ben, just because they actually had no idea that his part was going to grow into the size that it did. We had one group of writers in the first season, and between the first and second season, we changed all the writers except for one. And every time you have a new group of writers come in, they kind of want to put their stamp on things, and they felt like Ben's story was a good story to be told that we hadn't told. And so he really got a big bump in the second season, and they made him a regular. Before that, he was just recurring. And I think he's done a great job with it. And I really liked the second season. I felt like the first season was good, but we were laying the groundwork and sort of figuring out what it was. And then, he was such a major part of the second season that it was really a good catalyst to get things going, but still keep it human to an extent. That's what I like about the show, is that we don't get too ridiculously sci-fi. We try to anchor it with some of the human drama and the family aspect and how you'd really deal with things. Yeah, so I'd say he probably had the most change, but they've given us all some good stuff. Yes.
Can you see parts of Hal in you?
Definitely. Can I see parts of Hal in me? I feel like what any actor tries to do is, I think everybody has the ability to be anybody. It's just due to the circumstances you're in or whatever the case may be that you act a certain way, but you have the ability to be anything, and so you have to find that in yourself when you're playing these other characters. Like, what would I do if I was a little more this way or a little more that way? And that's what's really fun about it, is that you can act however you want. You can be in a bad mood with the character, be a little more this, a little more that, and